Meanwhile, few weeks after the death of Pastor Michael Sunday Ogunmoriyele, families, friends, colleagues, clergymen, amongst others, over the weekend stormed the venue of his burial ceremony at Christ Apostolic Church, Okeishegun, DCC headquarters, Ilawa-Ekiti, in Ekiti Southwest Local Government Area of Ekiti State, to bid him final farewell. Our correspondent, Ajala Adaku, was there and our report.
It was a celebration of life spent for humanity, nation building, selfless services and integrity as family members of late Pastor Michael Sunday Ogunmoriyele were joined over the weekend by clergymen, friends and associates at Christ Apostolic Church Okeishegun DCC headquarters Ilawa-Ekiti in Ekiti Southwest Local Government Area of Ekiti State to bid their farewell. In his sermon, the officiating minister described late Pastor Michael Ogunmoriyele as lover of God who served God's purpose for his family, work and his country. The children of late Pastor Michael Ogunmoriyele said although the death of their late father was painful, his impactful life and legacies were sufficient to console the family.
My father's life was like a book. I can't talk. There's nothing I'm going to say that's going to be enough. But he was a man that gave all. He sacrificed so much, suffered himself to make us have a better life than he had. And we did the little could do to make him have an elongated life, but death had his way. So we just have to thank God for his life. 84 years is not a joke in Nigeria. For him to have been sustained at that time is a good one. We thank God for the life he spent, and we'll continue to uphold his legacy because he was a man of integrity, a man of virtue, an hard worker, somebody who loved children and had compassion.
My late father was a loving father that anybody on this planet Earth would wish to have as a father. He was an amazing father, was a loving father to a fault. He was a father that sacrificed all for all his children, not minding whatever that could cause him. That's why the father that was married for close to I've been married for close to 19 years. He kept on monitoring my progress alongside the progress of my children, even my husband. We really miss him. We are missing him presently. And for the rest of our life, we'll continue to miss him.
He was my father. He was an hero. He was a disciplinarian, a mentor, a father like a mother, a selfless man. He sacrificed all he had. He gave up all he had. Even when it was so tough for him, just to ensure that all of us are somebody. And today, the prayer has been answered. That's why I will say that it's so painful we lost him, but we are not mourning. Rather, we are celebrating him.
He's a very good man, very kind, very caring. You know, when you say someone is caring, people don't really understand. It looks like the word people use generally just to qualify people. But we that felt that care from him, we understand what we are seeing. He's so caring. He sacrificed a lot to put our leg on the right path. A father that sacrifice all the life luxuries just to put all of us in the right path.
My dad lived a fulfilled life. He was a wonderful and loving, caring, sympathetic, emotional, and wonderful father. And he tried all his best to train all of us with no support from anybody except his wife. And he trained six of us successfully in university level. We thank God for his life, a life well spent. He loved me so much, being the last born of the family. He has never raised his hand to beat me before. even throughout my lifetime, throughout my lifetime with him before I got married. He was a wonderful and loving father, indeed.
I can describe late Michael Ogunmoriyele, which is my grandfather, by showing how he was kind to all of us and was always prepared anytime we want to come with him. What I miss him about is that he was always kind to us and very cheerful.
He will be described by me as a very accommodating father, because I'm actually his daughter-in-law, but for the past 18 years I've been married into this family, he has been so loving, so wonderful. In fact, he was so loving to the point where he actually gave me pet names. He had special names for me. Whenever I come around to visit, he calls me this special name just for me alone. Like names like my beautiful wife, my love, even over the phone. There was a day he actually spoke with me over the phone and my phone was in speaker and my husband was like, my love. You know, so it shows the degree of love he had inside his heart for me.
My father-in-law is such a great man that everyone should always pray for. He was kind to me. From the moment he graciously accepted me as his own daughter when I got married to his son, Olalekan, he filled the void of my father, my late father, when I lost my father. He was always calling me every day. Daddy will call me, sometimes he will call me, you know, in Ekiti dialect. Hello, omomi, mo kon wi ki mi gbohun re ni. Meaning, I just called to hear your voice. You know, he was such a caring father, loving. I'll miss him so much. I miss how he calls me, Mama WD, my beautiful wife. A lot of things I'll miss about him.
They thanked everyone who graced the occasion, wishing them safe trips to their various destinations.
I just want to thank them. They've been wonderful. So many of them have personal encounters with my father in his lifetime. So many of my younger ones, so many of my colleagues in his secondary school, they even said they wish he was their father because they knew the level of love and compassion he had on us when we were growing up. So, and they've done well. In fact, the burial became a celebrity burial for him because all of them said they must contribute to his burial because of his impact he had on their lives.
Honestly, I never knew my daddy was a celebrity until today. You know, we were surprising so many people that we have seen for so many years, that we have lost contact for so many years, but purposely because of celebrating my late father's funeral, they came around to celebrate with us. You know, not that they came alone. They spent money, they spent their time with us. It was all fun, and we bless God.
Yeah, I want to appreciate everybody that came near and far to celebrate with us. I want to say thank you, and I pray that God will grant all of you journey mercies, your various destinations, in Jesus' name. Thank you all.
We really appreciate them, and we pray that they go back safely, and I pray they shall all be celebrated alive in Jesus' name.
I just want to appreciate all my friends, family and friends, my friends from NICO Ibadan, my friends from Christ School, my friends from Ado, my friends from X School. I want to thank all of them and my friends that we grew up together, my childhood friends. I want to thank all of them for their support in cash, in kind, and physically for gracing the occasion. I want to really appreciate them, and I pray that we all have things of joy to celebrate together.
I thank everyone who has come from far and near for them to grace this occasion. I'm overwhelmed with the love I'm seeing around. Like, people came as far as Lagos, Abuja, Port Harcourt, and every other state in Nigeria. And I wish them journey mercies back, and I pray that God will continue to keep us together and give us long life like he did to our daddy.
We just want to thank them for coming to celebrate with us and wish them safe journey to their various places.
Late Pastor Michael Sunday Ogunmoriyele was born on 13th of August 1939 and died on the 6th of June 2023. His memories will remain dear to the people of Ilawe Ekiti and the history of Ekiti State in general. Angela Daku, reporting for Kaftan TV News.